My God, it's full of stars.
Alright, my little droogies. We got to the next installment of the time travel series. Project Rainbow, Project Pegasus, Project Montauk, and Project Phoenix. And we're going to begin this with a short clip from Al Bielek. He was supposedly one of the gentlemen involved in this a lot of these projects. And I used to think everything he said was complete bullshit, but the more research I do, the more it looks like he's involved. So here's Al.
That, in other words, there was a non-existent operation. There was no government coverage for it. There was no government payment. There was a surplus base which allegedly had nothing on it. So it was the perfect cover.
Where'd they get the funding?
It was totally private.
Yep. Private corporations?
Essentially. It didn't originally come from corporations. It did in the later phases. The original money came from the Nazis, the Nazi government. In 1944, there was a raid.
That was Phoenix 1.
No, that wasn't Phoenix 1. No, not Phoenix 1. This is Phoenix 2 and Phoenix 3.
Really?
Yep. In 1944, there was a American troop train that went through a French railroad tunnel carrying $10 billion in Nazi gold, which they had found. This isn't documented in a movie on the old Patton scenario, in which this train was dynamited in the tunnel, killed 51 GIs, and of course Patton, who was then in Europe, decided he had to investigate this. He couldn't understand how an American troop train in the Western Territory was dynamited in a French railroad tunnel. And he was concerned about the loss of 51 GIs, and also, as it turned out, $10 billion in gold disappeared. That was $10 billion in the valuation of the then existing European prices of $20 per ounce, not $400. The gold disappeared. It turned up 10 years later in the U.S. at Montauk. This has been verified since. And that money, that gold, was used to finance the project initially and for many years because the value went up, as the value of gold went up, to approximately $100 billion plus. And they spent all of it and ran out of money.
That's when they tapped IGT.
And that's when they tapped IGT, who then from that point on funded it, because IGT was owned by a certain German group known as the Krupps.
Okay.
So
when we go to Back to the Future, we see the Mr. Fusion home energy device several times. And it's really, in reality, a Krupps coffee grinder. We also see it in the movie Alien several times. There it is again in Alien. And so we have a connection to the Krupps coffee grinder. We have a connection to Joe DiMaggio, Mr. Coffee, the Yankee Clipper, which is a ship. So Joe DiMaggio is Mr. Coffee. This is one of our first clues that we're looking for Mr. Parkinson's, Mr. ALS, Mr. Diabetes. So there's the Yankee Clipper, Apollo CSM. And ITT made computers.
Though he did take care of my Bubba Gump money, he got me invested in some kind of fruit company. And so then I got a call from him saying, we don't have to worry about money no more. And I said, that's good. One less thing.
Miles an hour have downed major power lines, leaving hundreds of families without
personal computer. The Rainbow.
Two separate microprocessors, one for today's jobs, another for tomorrow. The Rainbow from Digital Equipment Corporation. Call 1-800-DIGITAL for the store.
So now we go to the movie The Shining, and we see Wendy has the only Polaroid Instamatic camera that had a rainbow on it. And they don't have a good picture of it here, but take my word for it. It's the rainbow camera from Polaroid with the 45-degree mirror.
If you know that in the few hours that we had together, we left a lifetime's worth.
Usted es muy hermosa, señora, y tengo pena decirle que me da $5 americanos. Pero si no, mi padre me va a pegar.
What did he just say?
He says you're a very beautiful señora, and he's ashamed to ask you for $5 American for this picture. But if he doesn't, his father will beat him.
Pretty good hustle, kid.
And Vivian Kubrick says that it's entirely possible my father worked with Pink Floyd. So this is Pink Floyd's song, Time. There's the rainbow Polaroid Instamatic camera with a flash on it. The one Wendy had didn't have a flash.
You're probably right. Now,
so the rainbow thing, exactly. The rainbow clue begins with,
are we going?
Dorothy and the Wizard of Oz.
Where the rainbow at?
Where the rainbow
so
is.
This clue set goes all the
don't
way back
go the
to the infancy of color films.
That depends where that
and,
is.
Well, let's find out.
The Wizard of Oz was
excuse
one of the first
me,
color
ladies.
Films.
Personal computer from Digital with two separate microprocessors. One for today's jobs, another for tomorrow. The Rainbow from Digital Equipment Corporation.
David Herdig and Scrabble Cheat is diverged. Diverge. So...
I don't really come from outer space.
Oh, L.J. Washington, he doesn't really come from outer space.
Don't mock me, my friend.
Get out of my chair!
It's a condition of mental divergence. I find myself on the planet Ogo, part of an intellectual elite, preparing to subjugate the barbarian hordes on Pluto. Even though this is a totally convincing reality for me in every way, nevertheless, Ogo is actually a construct of my psyche. I am mentally divergent. I am mentally divergent. In that I am escaping certain unnamed realities that plague my life here. When I stop going there, I will be well. Are you also divergent, friend?
All you have to do is drive the time vehicle directly toward that screen, accelerated 88 miles an hour.
So we have the Indians clue that we've been using through this whole puzzle.
Screen, I'm going to crash into those Indians.
All kinds of Indians. Indian motorcycle, Indian baseball, Geronimo skull, Geronimo crater, the Jeep Grand Cherokee Wagoneer, Johnny Gage, Jennifer Lawrence, yada, yada, yada. All the half-Indian and Indian actors that are involved in this puzzle. And, of course, we have the Krupps coffee grinder right in the back of it. Mr. Fusion. We have Hi-Ho Silver. So Hi-Ho Silver is the Lone Ranger, which we see the Lone Ranger Theater in Full Metal Jacket. We have Bird's Book Alone. We have Stallone, the Italian Stallion. And we have the William Tell Overture. That's in Clockwork Orange, which is basically the beginning of the Lone Ranger. So here we have the ending of the show. It's done with Happy Trails.
Until we meet again.
So we have clues to Van Halen. We have Diamond Dave. We have the Jack Daniels bass. We have Eddie Van Halen with a half Fender, half Gibson guitar that's handmade, hand-painted. He's an archetype guitar player from Holland, the Netherlands. So he's going to drive toward the... So once again, we're in a theater again. This is a drive-in theater. Vaya con Dios. So this is Les Paul and Mary Ford. Of course, Ford is in the puzzle. And Les Paul and Leo Fender were the two men that developed the electric guitar. He had the log guitar. And he invents the Les Paul guitar. And he was an amazing guitarist, by the way. So this was one of their biggest songs. It's Happy Trails. Vaya con Dios. So we're using music as clues as well. So the Beatles were Les One Paul after Paul died, or after Paul died. They were Les a Paul. So here he is driving toward the screen, the silver screen. And it's DeLorean, Johnny DeLorean, with the double gull-wing doors. The only stainless car ever made. And stains is a category. You have the stained glass windows by Frank Lloyd Wright. You have the stainless DeLorean. You have General Stains in Dr. Strangelove. His name is Stains. So I haven't completed the stains category. I know there's a brown stain on the mattress. So there's a category of stains. Stained glass, stains on the mattress. Stainless steel, the only stainless steel car ever, with the double gull wing doors, made by Johnny DeLorean. And it was made in Ireland, which is very unusual for an American car to be made in Ireland. So you have the cave, and of course there's a bear in it. So you have the Pooh crater, and all the categories of bears, the polar bear, the brown bear, the black bear, the bear rug, Smokey the Bear. I should have put that. I'll add that in later, all the bears. Now we're going to get a really bizarre clue that meant nothing until you knew the puzzle.
Hey, McFly! Thought I'd have told you never to come in.
So McFly is an insect, obviously, which we're going to cover in a minute here.
You look like him, though. Especially wear a dog ugly hat. You kin to that hay barber? What's your name, dude?
Mart.
So he tells him his name is Clint Eastwood, which is a throwback to a movie which we'll cover later. So the run of the litter, you know, we're talking about cats and dogs.
Hey now, boys, would you take a look see at these pearly whites?
So he's got the Nikkei moccasins.
Take a gander at them moccasins. What kind of skins is that?
So it turns out the Nikkei is a Nike missile.
Nikkei, what is that? Some sort of engine tog or something?
And there's the actual real Nike sneakers that have been developed now with auto laces. So Nike is, it turns out, is also, you know, it's a missile, yes. It's an auto lacing shoe that we see in Back to the Future, yes. And of course, it's a Greek god, so a goddess, actually. So she's a winged Greek goddess, and she rewards the victors of battle. And she sides with Jupiter slash Zeus, and of course Jupiter and Zeus are the same thing, and of course Jupiter has his eagle and his mighty lightning bolts, which he defeats Saturn, the god of time, with. So she sides with Zeus in the battle of the Titans, and Nike is also the beginning of the name Nicholas you know, Nikola. So we have Nikola Tesla. We have Nicole Kidman. So it fits in really well. It's a Greek goddess. It's a missile. It's a sneaker manufacturer, and these boots were made for walking. So that's Nike. So we got the blacksmith and the horseshoe, and I mean this theme of blacksmith, horseshoe, horse, big muley, crater, blackjack, red room. It goes on and on and on. There's all the horses and the shoes and the blacksmiths, and you know, these boots were made for walking. One of the things I want to mention is Kennedy's rider of this horse had one boot in backwards in the saddle. It's like a thing they do when you die. And so his horse, you know, he threw a shoe. His horse had the one boot.
Nobody calls me Mad Dog.
Mad Dog. I hate that name. I hate it.
So here we have all the descriptions of you're mad, you're crazy, you're nutty, you're fruity. You out of your fucking mind. Jack the Ripper was crazy. This man is clearly a psychotic. He lost his blue marbles. You got the fruits, the apple, the orange, the lemon, the lime. The lone nuts, Dr. Evil, I can see you're nuts. Some kind of joker.
Nobody calls me Mad Dog. Especially not some dooted up egg.
So now he starts doing a Michael Jackson dance, and he's lip syncing, he's singing Billie Jean. That's my girl. And he does the Michael Jackson woo at the end of this. So he's doing the moonwalk. So we were walking, we're trekking, we're stepping, we're giant leaping, we're quantum leaping. The reason Kubrick uses the jack is because Bunny's hot, you know, so we're quantum leaping and jumping from time. And of course, you know, Joe Jackson is born the same exact day Kubrick is, and he's singing Billie Jean, My Girl, Billie Jean, the Billie Jean King. Tennis Stadium, Arthur Ashe Tennis Stadium is Corona, Flushing, Queens. Billie Jean is born 11/22, Kennedy's death day. So she's a ping pong match with Kennedy. She's born on that day, Kennedy dies on that day. He wants him to dance now, so he does the Billie Jean King. Or Billie Jean, that's my girl. And he says, you better run, squirrel. So we're running, we're stepping, we're leaping, we're trekking, we're quantum leaping. So we're going to get our clue to David Lynch now. And all the Lincoln assassins were hung after the Lincoln killing. And yet, Kennedy, nobody really hung after Kennedy here. It's just whitewashed. So they're dragging him through off the horse. Right up to the clock tower. How fitting.
We got ourselves a new courthouse.
So now we're going to get a look at another gun clue. Specifically a Winchester gun clue. So it turns out the first Winchester repeating rifle that was made was called the Yellow Boy, which is another color clue. And all the Winchesters were 7-shot. So he's retrofitted this rifle with a telescopic sight, which wasn't available then. So Galileo invents the telescope. And he's also got a larger lever on it. So here's our insect clue. You know, it's Marty McFly. And he says, I'll shoot the flea off a dog's back. So we get a flea and a dog clue at 500 yards. So flea is the Red Hot Chili Peppers. And he's always saying, what are you, yellow? You get Douglas Needles. His name is Douglas Needles. So Douglas Fir Needles. It's a wood. We're using woods over and over and over in this puzzle. You know, Elm Street and Willow is Ron Howard and P- Pinewood Studios. And so here's all the insects that we've accumulated through this puzzle so far. And so when we hear I can shoot the flea off a dog's back at 500 yards, we're given the flea. Now, the bubonic plague was carried by the flea. So a lot of these fleas are disease-carrying, exactly like the Lyme's tick from Lyme, Connecticut, which coincidentally emerges in Lyme, Connecticut, right next to the military biological warfare facility where they were specializing in tick-borne diseases. So, you know, there's a coincidence for you. You know, was Lyme's really an accident? I don't think so. They planned that. And, of course, Lou Gehrig vacations right near Lyme, and then he gets ALS. So who knows what they really did. So here's our horseshoe clue. My horseshoe threw a shoe. So as I said before, Kennedy, he has one boot in the saddle of blackjack. So he threw a shoe. So here's all the Pegasus, the Unicorn, the Mustang, the Morgan, the Apollo's flying horses, the merry-go-round, you know, the Trojan horse is very hard to get out of, blackjack, trigger, silver, Mr. Ed. It Wilbur Crater. So if you have Wilbur Crater, you have Mr. Ed. Stopwatch, the horse, you know, it's a big clue to time travel. The Mare and the Moon. You know, they're all using Colt pistols throughout this movie. Now there's our whiskey clue. Fine Kentucky Red Eye. So you got the Kentucky rifle and the red eye. You know, we have the one eye Jack, and it just fits in so good. And then you got the D.H. Lawrence clue, which is 9/11. Indian. So he's giving the Indian clue right there. So we're distilling the moonshine. We're distilling the spirits. You know. So here's all the drinks. The Shirley Temple is on the Sergeant Pepper. She's redheaded. It's also a drink. The final shot by Jack Nicholson at the end of the movie. Apollo capsules, the translunar injections, the Saturn boosters, the Mercury program. Translunar injection, trans-Earth injection, the moon shots, the capsules, the Mercury program. This is eugenics we're looking at now. So we got the Johnny Walker, you know, O.J. plays Johnny Walker in Capricorn 1. So we're using these whiskey clues over and over and over. And, of course, Johnny Walker fits right in because we're walking, we're stepping, we're quantum leaping. Yeah, so here's all the horse clues.
That's $80. Look, if your horse threw a shoe, bring him back and I'll...
So we have Tim Carey shooting Red Lightning in the movie The Killing. Little Arnie. Little Arnie is Arnold Schwarzenegger. That is Red Lightning. So, you know, Sylvester Stallone is the Italian Stallion. You get the Bronco, the white Bronco for OJ. Spur Crater, Saddle Rock, Big Muley Rock. I mean, all the horse clues were all on the Apollo landing maps. A unicorn. And Blade Runner, the Pegasus pony, the Rainbow Pegasus pony is one of the cartoons included into. You know, you have Sirhan Sirhan, the stable boy, John Wayne, Roy Rogers, the Lone Ranger. He's giving you westerns, cowboys, the horses, the horseshoes, the saddles, the spurs. I mean, every conceivable thing related to a horse he's giving you.
Well, that's your problem, Tannen. Rolf, that's yours. So from now on, you better be looking behind you when you walk, because one day you're going to get a bullet in your back.
So So we're going to get some clues to the nuclear part of this puzzle. See, Marty wears a shirt with the atomic symbol on it. We see the atomic kid is...
Wow, this is a radiation suit.
Radiation suit? Of course.
Because of all the fallout.
We have Van Halen already,
force.
And one of their songs is the Atomic Punk. So we got the Dutch brothers, the handmade guitar, half Gibson, half Fender. Diamond Dave, play girl Bunny, or play girl Jack.
My girls,
so this is the pack of matches story. You know, we found the pack of matches and tried to burn the hotel down. This is Kennedy who fired the missiles at the dome with the Thor missile.
Tried to burn it down.
This picture here is just so alchemical, I could probably do a half-hour thing on it. We got the smiley faces from Forrest Gump. We've got Roger Rabbit. We've got the crystal bust of Kennedy's head. It says the population bomb. It's everyone's baby. That's one of our clues. The Jacks are reproducing at Fibonacci sequence. You got the Jaws movie, Spielberg clue. A blast from the past, if you look at this closely, is 1945. And they're referring to the atomic blast. The movie Back to the Future 2 comes out on Kennedy's birthday, or death day.
But it's good to see you, Marty.
You know, in the there's a scene where he says, where's Kennedy Drive in the movie? So he's given Kennedy Drive, blast from the past.
Hang. What idiot dressed you in that outfit?
You did. Young man, how about you? You want to
so
give
here's his
try?
Dancing clue. Have Gene Kelly, King of the Musical. So we're looking for people who are dancers, singers.
Son! Funny boy!
The dog can dance.
Son! Hey! I just told you that even a baby could handle this weapon. Surely you're not afraid to try something that a baby could do.
Yeah, I'm not afraid.
So it's a Colt single action revolver. So it's another horse.
Now, what you do is you just ease that hammer back there and squeeze off around. No.
And the guy that's in this scene, he's been in about a million.
Listen,
can I try that again? Yeah, go ahead. So it's a Colt Peacemaker, is the name of the pistol.
Just tell me one thing.
So
where
now
did
we're
you
in
learn
Back to the Future
like
2,
that?
And we see a lot of 7-11. The clues. We see the football. We see Reagan. We see the holographic hat.
Gun.
A crack shot. So you're cracking the code.
Kid.
You're cracking the puzzle.
We're crack
you're
shot.
Hacking it. You get the animal cracker. Crack Liberty Bell.
Can you use your hands? That's like a baby.
So he learned to shoot at 7-Eleven on a video game. The holographic hat. And Nancy and Ronald Reagan. So here we're going
to
get our whiskey clue, which we already had already, but we're going
to
double it again.
Amen. Helmet, no!
So you got the Kentucky Red Eye, you got the Wake Up Juice, which is made from hot pepper sauce. Juice. Rider. The Michael Collins, the bourbon, the brandy, the sherry, the grain alcohol, the Budweiser, the Jack Daniels, Hair of the Dog, we are distilling spirits.
Come on, Doc.
Commies drink vodka.
Give me some coffee.
You want to sober him up in a hurry, son, you're going to have to use something a lot stronger.
In the movie When Mars Attacks, Jack Nicholson says, every damn alcohol known to man I want in my limo. So he's telling you that he's using every kind of whiskey, wine, beer. If it has alcohol in it and it can be distilled,
he's
going to
be
in sober.
Tomorrow, the Martians land on Earth. They're going to need a place to stay, just like everybody else.
My God.
should all be destroyed. The human race doesn't deserve to live.
Ethel, that reminds me. I would like for every limo to be stocked with every kind of alcohol known to man. And top it off with a bottle of Dome on ice.
There's a priest on Sunday. 10 minutes.
A
Why
clothes
do we have to cut these things so damn close?
Here, stick this clothespin on his nose.
So there's all the pepper they're going to pour down
his
throat.
When he opens up his mouth, go ahead and pour it on down his gut. Oh, and stand back.
He's still out!
Oh, man, that was just a reflex action. Oh, it's gonna take a few more minutes for the stuff to really clear up his head.
Time's up, Runt. So now we're gonna mirror a Clint Eastwood movie. And remember earlier he used a Clint Eastwood name. So Clint Eastwood is one of our Woods in the puzzle. Just like we had Elijah Wood was the little kid playing the video game, the crack shot video game. And he's a Wood as well. So you have Natalie Wood, Elijah Wood, Elm Street, Willow. I'll make a list and put them under here, all the Woods. You know, a Wood is also a golf club class. You know, you have James Woods. Natalie Wood is in Rebel Without a Cause, and that's filmed at the Griffith Observatory. The Griffith Observatory is the tunnel that Danny drives through, or that Marty drives through on a skateboard. It's the Griffith Tunnel, and the Griffith Observatory has the Sun and Moon Telescope and a Foucault's Pendulum, which is one of our Flat Earth clues. And in Rebel Without a Cause, they drive the cars off the cliff, the crazy cliff.
I thought we could settle this like men.
So he shoots Marty. Wrong, but of course, we're mimicking the Clint Eastwood movie, so Marty has like a potbelly stove hung around his neck, which stops the bullet.
Thank
knocks him out, and he falls into the horse shit again. You know, it's always there's a whole category of shit, and horse shit, and mare. You better start shitting me, Tiffany cufflinks, and yada yada. They did a whole video on shit, and the shit repeats every one of these movies. He's either driving his car into the shit, or he's falling into the shit, or he's crashing his car into a dump truck in the shit. So let's take a look at the movie that this came from. So we have Clint Eastwood. So that's interesting. We have a wood and a cowboy.
You
may kind of dead.
Don't you want to see me?
You may kind of dead.
So Tarantino mentions that he loves all these old Western movies. So I have a feeling that all these old Western movies are filled with this stuff, and I have not watched, you know, this would require a month of watching these things.
What's wrong, Ramon? You losing your touch? Afraid, Ramon.
I was mentioning the heart. So you got hearts, Hearts, diamonds, spades, clubs.
Shoot to kill, you better hit the heart. Your own words, Ramon.
If you notice in the clip with Marty, he shoots everyone in the shots through the heart.
The heart, Ramon. Don't forget the heart. Aim for the heart or you'll never stop me.
And we've got a Winchester lever action model. Oh, geez, I don't know. But it's a seven shot. And he uses all his seven shots pretty soon here. And it looks to be a 45-70, so I have a feeling a 45-70 would go right through that small plate he has on, but in the movie it doesn't, so. So Clint is the, you know, the badass cowboy with Wood in his name. You know, you had Operation Northwoods, and you have Clint Eastwood. So here we have our trains thread. You know, we have no tracks is repeated throughout the puzzle because when you time travel, you don't travel between two points. You jump between the two points. So you leave no tracks at all. You're from point A to point B instantaneously, just like the transporter system in Star Trek. And I don't know what the hell's going on here. So Doc has to save Mary Steenburgen, otherwise she's not going to be in all the other time travel movies she's in. That's another thing I'm noticing. We have Mick Jagger is in the puzzle already. He's born the same day as Kubrick is. And when you research Mick Jagger, you know, he's in the Rolling Stones. And obviously, we have Rolling Stones magazine, Rolling Stones band. And we have Ron Wood is in the band. But on top of that, we find out that Mick Jagger is also in a movie called Free Jack. So once again, we have a Jack, and we have a Sheen. We have Emilio Estevez is in the movie Free Jack. I cannot find a copy of that thing anywhere online, and I don't own any of these Back to the Future movies. These are all clips from online, so I'm finding it difficult to find some of these movies. So this is our tracked clue. We have a one track. You know, John D. Rockefeller was Mr. Railroad. Jack the Ripper. So this is the Clayton Pass. I forget what they call it. And this stunt, this special effect looks so real. And it wasn't a real train, it was a model. They did a hell of a job on that scene right there. So Marty travels through time, he's on the tracks. And there's DeLorean. With the windows that only go halfway down. And this is mirroring Ronald Barron, who's run over by a train with his whole family in this VW bug, and he's killed instantly. He was investigating the Apollo 1 fire. And I wanted to show one more thing before the end of this video. I wanted to take a look at the Apollo 17 landing map, which I did not have a good copy of. But now I got a good copy of the map, and it's blowing my mind, all the stuff that was on there that I missed. There's a flux capacitor. A magnetic flux is measured in Tesla.
It's destroyed. Just like you wanted.
So here's the Apollo 17 landing map. And let me pause this for a second and get this thing bigger here. So if we look at this, we see the North Massif. You know, this is a massive turd. We see Cochise Crater, which is a famous last of the Apaches fighting. We have Henry, so these would be Hank Aaron and Tom Hanks. We see Shakespeare, so this is Horatio Crater, Shakespeare. We are all actors on a stage. So we have Camelot Crater. This is our clues to King Arthur. C. Clarke. Horatio Crater. Frosty. Stay Frosty is a line that Bill Paxton uses in the movie Aliens. So it's Frosty the Snowman. It's Snowman we're talking about here. Trident Crater. This would be one of Neptune / Poseidon's attributes. So we see Woody Strode with Neptune's trident. And it's also a missile. And of course, Neptune is the father of all horses. He creates Pegasus. So we have a time travel clue right on the Apollo 17 map itself. We have the towers. So we had North Twin, South Twin on Apollo 15. Now we have the towers. We have the Snoopy Crater and Charlie Brown capsules. We have, what else is on here? Lincoln Scarp, so there's a clue to the Lincoln killing and the Lincoln killing date. We have Stonewall Jackson, very famous Civil War. You have Emily Bronte, that's July 30th, that's the day they land on the moon on Apollo 15. This is a very interesting one. We have Hole in the Wall. Robert Redford ran the Hole in the Wall facility where they would take kids that were dying, really sick kids, and they would send them up to the hole in the wall facility where they would spend the rest, you know, they would have fun up there. They would watch the airplane fly over, and it was a place where they would let kids go to that were dying of horrible diseases. So I find it very interesting that we have Robert Redford's Hole in the Wall facility in here. And of course, you have the Hole in the Wall gang. And we have Lewis. So we have Lewis Carroll and the Lewis machine gun. We have Victory. This is the message that was sent over Morse code the day Kennedy is murdered. They typed Morse code for the word victory after they killed Kennedy. We have Arms. So these are all the guns clues that we're looking for in the puzzle. And we have Rudolph, the red-nosed reindeer. The Mariner probe. So Mariner is somebody who's a seaman, is a mariner. So these are your clues to all the ships that are in our puzzle. What else is on here? Steno. So these are, I'm not going to go into that right now. We have the Hess. So Hess is a petroleum company, and we have the Hess toy truck that's given for Christmas. This is really clever here. You have Bear Mountain on the bottom of this. Kubrick would know what Bear Mountain is. He lived in New York. Bear Mountain is one of the flat earth places. If you climb Bear Mountain, which I've actually climbed Bear Mountain, you can see Manhattan from the top of Bear Mountain. And if we lived on a globe, you really shouldn't be able to see Manhattan from Bear Mountain. So it's a clever clue because it gives you a bear, which is, we have the clue, all the category of Pooh Bear and Smokey the Bear and the Bear Carpet and the polar bear, and then it's giving you the mountain clue. So we have the Columbia, we have all the mountains that are in our puzzle, and also it's a place where you can see if the earth is flat in New York, which Kubrick would know where Bear Mountain is. He lived in New York. What else is on here? Jefferson. So we have a president. Presidents are a thread. So you have Washington and Jefferson, and there's a whole bunch of them in here. You know, Truman and Eisenhower and yada, yada, yada. So when you find a movie and the name of the movie is The Truman Show, you immediately have one of the threads to this puzzle. It's one of the U.S. presidents. So as you do this puzzle, you're going to find U.S. presidents all over. And of course, a lot of the presidents have a coin as well, and they'll have some kind of historical, a famous historical story about each president will be included in the puzzle as well. And Walden, God, I should know. I forgot what that one is. Anyway, this map is ripe with clues, and I have only had it for 2 days, so I don't have them all here. But we can see the Indians clue, we can see the president's clue, we can see a lot of the clues that we're looking for on this, including the towers, the Twin Towers. And one of the more important ones is here is the Trident crater, because this is a clue to Neptune and his trident, which we see Woody Strode with his trident, which is also a missile, which is also a gum, which is also he's also the father of all horses, including Pegasus, which is one of the names of the time control or time travel program that they ran. And that's it, guys. I know it took me a while to do this. I had a really bad bout of writer's block, and also I'm back working now, so I don't have as near as much free time as I used to have. And there will be a part seven to this. I mean, it seems almost never ending. The more I research this topic, the more I find. The more I find, I just keep finding. What I did this week is I downloaded almost every movie I could find on time travel and watched all of them at least 3 times. And there's 2 other movies I want to cover, and I doubt anyone in the audience has ever seen them because I had never seen them, and I love time travel movies, so. And that's it, guys. Peace and love. I hope you enjoyed this. If you did enjoy it, please thumb it up, because I don't make a freaking dime off these. And YouTube is going to make damn well sure I never make a dime off these. And it's probably going to take me 5 times to post this thing where I'm going to have to blur every fucking screen on it just to get it to go. But whatever. You know, however vast the darkness, we must supply our own light. And that's it. Peace and love, guys. Carpe diem.
Serving a life sentence for his conviction in the 1968 shooting. And the search continues in the mountains near Ouray today for that missing Aspen woman.